Welcome to Pipl Systems, a YouTube channel dedicated to security professionals, where we review security products on how to use them, how to install them, and mostly if they're released to the market and how you can use them for your projects. Today, we're answering questions from the community, and one popular question that we received was about hard drives. So, what size of hard drive should I get to store the information for my security surveillance system? This has a lot of factors to it. Today we'll see all the factors you need to understand to choose the right size of storage for your solution. We will show the formula on what actually happens on the storage unit when you record from your video surveillance. And we will show the tools you can use to calculate on your side the size of storage you need for your projects. Let's get right into it. All right, so which factors you need to consider when building your security surveillance system for your storage space? Well, first, how many cameras do you need? Do you need 4? Do you need 16? That's a valid point to have because 1 and 16, well, it varies in the storage space you need. Then each camera have a set frame rate. So you might choose one camera at 15, one camera at 30. That's something you need to consider again. You also need to consider the resolution of your camera. From time to time, we'll put 4K cameras in the front entrance. This way we have a better image of the face of the individual that comes to the office. But the others can be at 1080p. So this way, well, it takes less storage space on your server. So keep that in mind. Every step of the way, it's something to consider to save space. That's what we want to do right there. Then, how many days are you recording? Again, is it a 7 days a week, 24 hours a day server? Because you're recording maybe some facility that needs all the information there. Or are you recording a retail store? So maybe you don't need the cameras to be active all day long. And finally, which compression ratio will you be using? Because if you're using H.264, well, it's different than H.265. This technology varies a lot in the number of storage space it will take on your disk. And I'll go more in detail into that just for you, so you understand better the difference between H.264 and H.265. The difference between H.264 and H.265. H.264 is an advanced video coding. H.265 is an high efficiency video coding. H.264 is used across the board. Any cameras, any servers that you use will be able to take the H.264 compression. But honestly, if you want my honest opinion, try to find H.265. It's getting there. It's in almost every product now you can find it. It's a little bit more expensive, but trust me, it's worth it. Because at the end of the day, you're saving on storage space and you keep the image quality even better than H.264. That means that if you record in 4K, because you're compressing the information on the hard drive, you may lose some quality when you're using H.264. That's where H.265 is way better because it will keep and maintain the image quality directly on the hard drive. And even nowadays, we have technologies such as H.265 Plus, AI H.265. So if you want to spend a little bit more, that's other technologies you can look into. But be sure to check the data sheets of your product and find this compression ratio right there. Now that you know all the factors you need before choosing your video size storage, what tool can you use? Because, okay, you have all the factors, but it doesn't say much about the storage size, right? So many manufacturers of hard drives, such as Seagate, Western Digital, and others in the market, have storage tools directly on their website. Today, we're gonna use one from Seagate, just so we can put everything we've learned into practice and see how it actually calculates the storage size you need. So you go on Seagate.com, you open their storage calculator, and as you can see here, you have all the factors we just discussed. So the number of cameras, the frame per second, the number of hours per day you're recording, the number of days you need the data stored, and the compression type, which is the H.264, H.265, and the video quality. So if you're recording in 4K, or maybe in 1080p. Now, here, I like this example because let's say you're using all the data here. So 12 cameras, 15 FPS, 12 hours a day, 15 days that you need to keep the data stored on your hard drive, and you're going with a H.264 compression ratio. So that's the compression algorithm that is on your camera and your server. And now you see that for 12 cameras, you will need 1.46 terabytes of data to store everything for 12 days. But what if you're using H.265? So let's click here. As you can see, we're now in the gigabytes. So you're saving a lot of space by using H.265. Again, just by seeing this, it should tell you that H.265 is really the way to go. Again, I think it's getting there in the fact that it's popularized enough to be in most of the product, but when choosing a camera or a server, look at the data sheet and make sure it's there. And if it's a little bit more expensive, well, as you can see, you're saving space in the storage. So you will need to buy less hard drive for your server. So I think it's a good bargain. Now we see the tool, we have the factors, but what's happening behind this tool? So what's the exact calculation to get this number? We will not go into too much detail, but I think that showing you the formula will make you understand even more what's happening for your storage side. Maybe it can even help during to code a project, because you can tell the end user how it works. And the explanation is pretty simple, honestly. So we'll look at that together. All right, guys, as promised, here's the formula behind the tool we just used. So it will be easier for you to understand what's the calculation behind the storage space used on a hard disk. So first off, you need to understand and find the bitrate. The bitrate is the data that will be written on your hard drive per second. So that's the data it uses. To find the bitrate, you need to calculate the resolution of the camera, its frame per second, and the compression you will be using. So if it's H.264 or H.265. Keep in mind that right now we're doing a calculation for one camera. If you want to use multiple cameras, maybe you use the same cameras for all the installation, well, you do this formula times the number of cameras. And if you use different, because like we said earlier, maybe you're using one 4K camera, maybe one has a H.264, the other has a H.265, well, you need to use the formula for all different cameras. When you find the bitrate, we need to understand the recording duration per day in seconds, because we're using bitrates. And this will give you the number of hours you're recording every day. So number of hours per day, times the number of minutes, times the number of seconds. So this will bring this number, it's in seconds, for you to use in the next formula, which is the total recording duration. So this way you will understand with this camera, how many hours of recording you need on your hard drive and the space it will take in bit. So total recording duration, recording per day, number of days of the total recording duration. Now you have these two numbers that goes together to calculate the storage required, which is the bitrate times the total recording duration. And then you divide it by 8. The reason for that is that 8 bit equals 1 byte. And when we're talking about storage space, we're always talking about bytes. So gigabytes, terabytes. So it's easier for you to calculate the number of storage space you would need in your disk if we transfer the bits to byte. That was the formula for you to understand how the calculator works. I think it's a good way to show the end user that you know how it works. And it's also a good way for you to understand how it works. And I just feel that then you can understand better the storage space you need every time you're building a project. All right, so we've seen how to choose the right storage space you need for your security surveillance systems. Remember to always get a little bit more storage than what you see on your screen if you're using the tool. Simply because we're in the security sphere, so it's always better to prevent anything that can happen. So if you go directly for the right amount that you see on your screen, it may be less than what you will really need in another situation. So get a little bit more. Again, if you like this video, give us a subscription, leave a comment below. Give us feedback. We always read those comments. As you can see, we even do videos about them. And if you're a security manufacturer of professional system, well, send us an email. Maybe you have a new product on the way. You have a technology that is still unknown and you would like to share with a community of professional security technicians. And this is why we're here, So keep looking at our YouTube channel, contact us, and we will see you on the next one. Thank you.